Welcome. In today's video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about this, the Power BI KPI card. I'm going to teach you how to completely format and unlock all the capabilities of this visual. Notice that it's interacting. The background changes, the conditional formatting changes. I'm going to show you how to unlock all these features, building stunning, beautiful KPI cards. Let's dive into Power BI Desktop. Let's go. All right, so here we are. We're in Power BI Desktop. What we're going to do is build these KPIs. What you need to do right now is go to the description of this video, open up the GitHub file that's there. You can follow along with exactly what I'm doing. After you go through this process, you're going to be equipped, man. You're going to know what to do with your own data for how to use these KPI cards. So what we're going to do is first talk through the data set, then build these KPI cards. You're going to be good to go. Okay, so what's important to understand is that what the KPI visual does first is it's going to display a callout value, which is going to be an aggregate. It's going to be here's the number of sales, here's the number of whatever against a goal. And what you're going to actually do is compare it against one to two, ideally two goals, multiple goals. It will return a value, but then importantly, if you set it up correctly, it will trend the information behind it. So this just hits viewers with all kinds of information. You're going to get the value, you're going to get a chart, you're going to get color. You're going to get everything to quickly understand, is this going well, is it going poorly? So let's look at the data, because first you need to understand the data that you're working with so you can unlock it in the visual. What I have here are net sales. It's going to be in the data model, very simplistically, a net sales that's going to add up the total of net sales, but it's going to do it for every store. So these are store names on the bottom left-hand side. Let me zoom in. On the bottom left-hand side, there's a store, and every month my data model is going to show, here's the net sales, the goal, every store has a monthly goal, and then the delta of that goal. This is for visualization. It's going to calculate the goals and the percentages, and I'll show you that. But it's important to understand that then those can be rolled up. So every single month, a store has a goal, every store is grouped. And these KPI cards, you want KPI cards to be at a higher granularity. It's not like you're going to have a KPI card for every individual customer. You're going to have it for groups or sales reps or collections or managers. So this is grouping stores together into regions, Far West, Far Plains, etc. And then an overall. What you're going to notice is that it interacts with all of the different sliders, changing over time. The dates change with it. The time range changes with it. And interacting with filters. This filter right here, there's a slicer video. I put it right here in the corner of this. If you click that, you'll be able to follow along with how to unlock this really cool slicer. Build everything you need to with that. So let's dive in now. If you have any questions around the data model, feel free again to open it up and look at it. But at a quick high level, you'll see that the model is going to take a store and connect it to a sale. And then for every store, there's going to be a monthly goal. So if we look at what that looks like, there's lots of sales, tons of sales happen, but every store, here's the store, is going to have a goal in the region of that store, a net sales goal and a high goal. So when you set your goals in the data, we'll get into why, but you can have like a low goal and a high goal, and following values will range in between those. But let's start. Let's dive in. Once we build one, it's going to be quicker to build the rest, but it's important in this exercise so you can understand how to quickly modify these, because you're going to have more than one KPI card. So you need to know how to work with this. So we're going to start right now. What we're going to do first is build a KPI. So we're going to insert the KPI card. Very straightforward. The cool thing about these visuals is they're not too hard to configure if you know what you're doing and how to, you know, subtly improve the formatting of it so it just looks sharp. And how to unlock the target section. We're gonna go through all these and then every formatting opportunity for the visual. So for this, just to start with what to do, add your key callout value. You'll notice nothing shows up. Okay, I added net sales. It doesn't show up. So let's add the target. And within my data model, we know that there's a net sales goal right over here. I'm gonna add that to target. Still nothing shows up. Okay, why is that? Because the KPI card must be evaluated against time or the trending. So what we have as well in our data model is going to be the date. And we have a, if I make this a little bit smaller so I can see versus that my video right there, you'll see that there's a year month number. I'm gonna add this into there. And what that's, this is that value right here, 2023-01, 02, every month. You're gonna have a single value that's gonna aggregate this up. If you wanted to trend it by day, you can do that as well. And it will be a much more granular chart. You want to make sure that your goals and your targets are aggregating appropriately at the day level. This model is set for monthly aggregation. So when you first create the visual, it's going to start like this. And we're going to show you how to go from this to this, as well as the yellow formatting. The yellow is a little bit trickier to get in that middle zone. Red is good. Green's good. Red's bad. Or you can make green bad, you know, up and down different colors. I'll show you all of that. So let's walk through first. We're going to nail in the all regions and then quickly separate and create these other ones. Follow along with this exercise. So what we're going to do is we are going to go through each portion of the formatting section for this. So let's dive in. With every KPI card, what I like to do is I do think these look pretty solid with the shadow. It just seems like, you know, the KPIs, they're those cards that kind of float in the beginning. You can use your own style and taste for this, but if you go to shadow, you can turn that on. And very simplistically, you know, it's going to set up the shadow for you. The title is something that is important as well, because especially as you have multiple KPI cards, you're going to have a descripting title. Sometimes they say, don't mess with the title, and this one, we want to show it. So what we can do is come up and you can actually change the title in the text section. I'm going to call this all regions because I'm not formatting or I'm not filtering out anything. What I like to do as well is intentionally create a kind of a section for the title. And if I look over here, I'm just going to pick the same color that I have all the threes. So we're going to go to the title section, change its background color to all those threes, and the title size just a little bit bigger, 16. What you'll notice as well is there's some slight spacing there. So we're going to get in there and tweak this spacing too. We want to have everything kind of flush and lined up, and I'll show you how to do that. So for this, with the padding and the sizing, I like to make things kind of holistically the same. So you can see it's a little bit wider. I'm going to set all these to 3. Cool. I just kind of like, and we'll continue to adjust that as we go through this process. But now we have this all regions KPI. Let's look at some different sections of it now. Let's get the data going in there, because you can tweak the formatting of the overall size and style to meet your liking. It's very variable, whatever you choose. So let's look at the callout value first. Here's some key things that I like to do with callout values. Well, obviously the size and location of it. You want it to be bold. You want it to be really prominent in the front. You can choose to bold it if you want. Sometimes the colors themselves will do that job. I do like to have the display units because there's so much space typically here to be none. I like to have it just straight up. Here's the value. And the decimal place is typically none. Now the icon is going to be next to it. And this is where it's going to show just another symbol to say this is a positive or this is a negative. Over here on the left, you can see negative or neutral, doesn't really matter. And that's comparing things to goal, which we'll look at as well. So I like the icon to be bigger. I think over here I made it 25. So make it relative to the size of your callout value. Maybe for spacing, you can't have quite a big as big of a one, but make it appropriate so it's not too tiny or too big. Now the callout value is set up, the icon set up, and these things are automatic, which is nice. But there's going to be things that you have to set up, especially with this yellow, to make it work and just to understand everything that's happening here. So now the trend axis, it's going to default to a range of colors, and I'll talk through each of these as well. But what I like to do is put them to the same color palette that I'm using for my overall dashboard. Don't leave them on the default. You'll notice things are different here as well. So we're going to keep messing with that. What I mean specifically is the transparency. Depending upon your likings, you know, you can really bold these things out so you're seeing exactly what's going on in the background. You can make it much lighter. I don't like the lightness. I kind of like it in the middle somewhere. And you can play with where you like it. I think in this visual, I chose 45, one of my favorite numbers. So I'm going to put 45 here. Just overall, I dig how it looks. All right, so we have this going, but let's look at a couple of the final sections. And again, they're not hard to configure, but they take your dashboard to the next level. So now in the values, the target label, you can change some things up. I like to separate I'm intentionally bolding one area and I won't bold the other. And I'll show you what these mean as well. Also, what happens typically in these dashboards is the font changes. Like DIN is up here, DIN's in the title, not here. I like to have it all the same. So this, I think I use DIN over here. Yeah. So make sure your fonts are the same. It just subliminally makes things connect, make things seem more holistically together. But what you can do is you can change the label. So maybe in this, just to show, I'll put target goal. Expands the whole word. So we can see that all regions, they earned a net sales of $311,000. The target goal was $207,000, which means they're above the goal by 49.71%. I mean, that helps so much. The distance to goal is what this is called. And we have so much space, I like to show more information. So there's different things you can show here. You can do percentage, values, or both. I'm going both. I want to show exactly the amount of the variance up $103,000 as well as the percentage of variance. The decimal places, let's reduce those. We can save some space. And this is where you can change the direction of things getting good or bad, if increasing is good or decreasing is good. So the final step is I like to include the date. I want to enable this date. And with my picture there, it's a little tricky to click on it. But within that section, there is a date. And you can enable that date, and it will show up here at the bottom, just like this. If I come over here. Yeah, that's hilarious. I just can't get to it because my image is there. But you turn that on, the date's going to show up. So then what happens next? Actually, let me do this real quick. Let's go. Oh, watch out. Moving things around. Getting crazy. There we go. Turned it back on. So now within this date, I kind of like to differentiate that as well. Make it a little bit lighter. It's not as important, but the date is critical because here's one thing about the KPI cards that are clutch. Is they're going to always show the most recent. So this of your series, of whatever you're segmenting it by. Specifically, if I click this, you know, the trend axis is year month number. So it's gonna show the most current year month, $311,000 for net sales, $311,000 for net sales. Let me close all these, collapse all, it's showing now the most recent. This is where this date slicer is important. If I want to bring this back, well, now it's taking things up to May. And we can see May 6th. Maybe I want to make it specific, May 31st. So that month isn't as good. Lots of stuff in the red, total negatives. But we can see that it's validating where we had net sales of $95,000. The goal was $207,000, under $112,000. And there you go. So that's very important. And now what you can do is after you create one KPI card, a quick way to set these up so you can build a nice suite of cards is to copy one, set it up, and filter it. So under the filter section, you can click it on the filters for this visual. The store doesn't show up, but I'm going to add the store region to the filter. And so I'll call it Far West. And you can see now that this filters up. What you can do as well is you want to make sure these things space out. So I went through the process of just looking at the size and style, picking the right width so it all checks out. In this case, the width 885, we'll make this 885. this width 280. So we'll do this width 280. And now we're cooking. We're gonna go view, page view, fit to width. So we have one, and now just copy these suckers. The good thing about the spacing is that Power BI has this intuitive spacing capability, so it will put the KPI visuals in the correct spot. But hang on, because there's a, I need to show you one more thing about the multiple targets, about how to do this Southwest. So just, it's a muscle memory thing, it takes 2 seconds, but go through the process of just updating these. Click one. And doing repetitive tasks just enable you to become more and more confident with how to use Power BI in a very simplistic way. So just knock these things out. It takes no time at all. We're gonna go change this one from Far West to Great Lakes. We're gonna change this one to Atlantic. We're gonna change this one to Rocky Mountain. We're gonna change this one to Southwest. All right, that quickly we set things up. You'll notice this Southwest one is different. So let's talk about that. What we can do quickly as well is we have those filters set up. Now let's just update the title. So you can actually, with the new formatting capabilities, just click right in it, which is very nice. You used to have to go into a menu, but now you can just edit the visual right there. So let's take a minute to update these. If you need to go into the visual, you can see it's actually just shortcutting us right over there. You can always go to that section under the visual title to add that. And we're almost done. Rocky Mountain and Southwest. All right, so here's the final important thing. You have two options for the goal, and I made this card different intentionally. You can see that all the other cards say the target goal, which is the amount that we said is the single target, and then the variance of that target. What you can do as well, and it's the only way to unlock the yellow or in the middle, the neutral color, is you set a threshold. You say, here's the minimum value, here's the maximum value. If the callout value, the total sales, is below that minimum one, it's going to be red. If it's above the maximum one, it's gonna be green. And if it's in between the two of them, it's gonna be yellow, neutral. And so you can see that it shows in this case that the goal is 7,000 minimum, 29,000 high. So what that looks like is in the same data model, for every single store, again, there's a goal, the net sales goal, which is what we've been working with, and then there's a high goal. I did this intentionally just so you could understand how it works. It's great when you need things to be within a spectrum. And so what you can do is when you come to the visual, if you add multiple targets, it's going to unlock the capability of that yellow or neutral zone to be utilized. So when I add high goal, it does it automatically because this is $28,000 net sales. The target goal again is $29,000 or the high. So it's in between that neutral zone. And just like that, you've mastered the cards. These things are so simple, but they're so key. And if you do these subtle formatting things, it's just gonna make it look awesome in your dashboard. So have fun with Power BI. If you found this helpful, hit subscribe, hit like, hit notify, leave some comments. I'm excited to keep building things and have a great day. Take care, bye.